Hi, fellas. Don't you like your billing?
Oh, just great.
How about you, Doc? You with it?
Not afraid so.
Yeah, I thought you would be. But just in case you two don't get the complete picture, I'm going to diagram it for you. Now, you see, you two are going to be in the lab here. And this little bottle of nitroglycerin is going to be right here on the doorknob. The only door that leads into the place. And so if you turn the knob from the inside, that bottle is going to hit the floor and then... Boom! And in case you think you're going to wait there until somebody will bail you out, I got that figured out, too. That's what the heat is for. I'm just going to push it right up there. Hey, Doc. Hey, boy, quick. What's the explosive point? 260 degrees centigrade, remember? Any questions? Hey, how about you, Doc? You look thoughtful.
Oh, I was just wondering about that soldier you strangled during the war. Did you volunteer to do that?
I might have.
That's what your father would have wanted, isn't it?
What's the difference?
Oh, it makes a big difference. It's been a source of anguish to you ever since it happened, hasn't it? Because you're equally convinced that your mother would have been opposed to it.
All right, now, Doc, let's not start that again.
What would you personally have wanted to do?
I told you what I did. I made a decision. I volunteered.
No, no. Your personality was a battleground for your parents, and they're still fighting. Only now there are conflicts inside your mind. But you'll never satisfy them both, Jocko.
Oh, that's what that was, huh? All that jazz about my welfare. You were just stalling, weren't you, Doc?
I told you it was my birthday. People are likely to drop in all night to congratulate me.
Probably Inspector Jenkins.
He's not going to be here until the morning, smart guy.
Well, he may have changed his mind. He wants those reports.
Well, I'll tell you what we'll do, gentlemen. We'll just invite him in. Well, I guess we don't have to.
Why don't you guys answer the phone?
Who's he?
Little Lord Fauntleroy.
This is nitroglycerin. Put on your package and join the party. Somebody hadn't told me, I wouldn't have believed it.
What wouldn't you believe, Jocko?
That so many people have the same lousy luck I have?
Two innocent bystanders complicate things for you, don't they?
Oh, you think so? Into the lab.
Why kill two innocent men when your quarrel's with me?
Because I can't afford any witnesses.
No,
they won't. Nobody will know.
You will.
Stop conning me and get into the lab.
What's his problem?
The doc will explain it to you.
I'd much rather explain it to you, Jocko. You didn't want to kill anyone tonight. That's why you came here an hour early.
I came here because I didn't want to miss the 9:28 deadline.
Not really. You wanted to use that hour in order to flaunt your intellectual achievements. To make up for what you considered to be a defeat before the parole board 5 years ago. You might even have wanted to use that hour to talk out your aggressions so that you wouldn't have to kill.
I'm gonna kill because I want to.
But why, Jocko? Why? To prove yourself?
Shut up!
Ah, that's it, isn't it, Jocko? You still regard every daily occurrence as a challenge to your masculinity. Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Remember, Jocko, starting with a rat you didn't want to kill 25 years ago. And the man you felt compelled to strangle during the war. That also plagues you, doesn't it? The thing that's goading you the most was your wife leaving you.
Oh.
Oh, that was the crowning blow, wasn't it, Jocko? Because inside you know that it wasn't my fault or anyone else's, but simply that she couldn't live with a man who confused violence with virility. A man who was still trying to please a savage father. Isn't that why she won't see you after your behavior the other night? Isn't that why you're confused now, Jocko? Why you can't kill three innocent men? Because inside you're neither soft nor savage, but a very confused human being.
Thank you.
doing?
You did, Doctor.
Hey!
Hey, Maury! Good! Very good.
Yeah, but why'd you get out of the lab? Oh, Doctor, nitro, it's gonna go up!
No, Jocko, no. You see, it wasn't really nitro. I'm sorry if I disappointed you.
What? Oh, Doc, I'm grateful.
I'm grateful to you, Jocko, for coming back.
Say, what do you think of Jocko's chances, Doctor?
Yes, what about that, Carl? Wasn't his coming back to rescue us a good sign?
No, oh, the best of signs, I say. Shows that our man had a sense of morality. That he no longer has to resort to violence in order to prove the fact that he is a man.
But what I want to know is, how did you manage to fool him with the chemicals?
Well, you know, I haven't had a mislabeled bottle of chemicals in my lab since I was a graduate student, but by a strange quirk of fate, yesterday, I emptied one of the bottles of acid. I needed it to store a saline solution, so I filled it with a mild alkaline.
Neutralizing the acid, huh?
Precisely. Thereby creating an ineffective base for our friend Jocko's formula.
You know, you could have saved me a lot of worry by letting me in on the secret.
Chacun a son goût. That's French, you know.
Oh.
Happy birthday, Carl.
Well, thank you, gentlemen.
To the pride of San Francisco, in the tweed suit.